Welcome back. Marcia Dick joining us from the city of Kamloops, where she works as the solid waste services analyst. It's great to have you.
Great to be here,
yes.
Susan. Thank you.
We're not talking so much about solid waste today as we are, though, about recycling.
Yeah.
Some new measures in place. Recycle BC has launched some new initiatives, Marcia, to allow us to recycle more.
Yes. Mm-hmm. So on June 1st, Recycle BC launched a pilot program to recycle what they're calling other flexible plastic packaging. And so this is all those crinkly, non-stretchy type of bags that used to not be able to recycle. So this pilot program will be initiated from now until January, where they'll be collecting as much of the material as they can to develop the technology to recycle it, because right now it's currently not recyclable.
Okay.
So it's a partnership between Merlin Plastics and Recycle BC to create the technology.
Tell me this, this isn't curbside recycling we're talking about.
No.
This is about taking it either to general grants or...
Actually, just the two general grants have signed up to... Yeah, so
okay, so let's look at what some of the examples are so people know. I'll move this out of the way a little bit so we can get some shots. Here.
So there's some slides that also kind of walk you through this, but so it's like all these like chip bags that have like foil linings, and now you can have like, you know, a guilt-free bag of chips knowing that you can recycle the bag.
Knowing that you're recycling the bag, which makes it absolutely okay to eat the whole bag.
So foil-lined material.
Yes.
So that's like all your granola bar wrappers, your candy bar wrappers, your chip bags, like lots and lots of stuff. I can't even imagine what else.
Yes.
All this, like this is a bag from Prawns, and it's like, it doesn't stretch.
Right.
It's very rigid, sort of. So that, it's like crinkles, you know, if it makes that sound.
Yeah.
And sealed for freshness is another one of the things. So some of these with zipper tops. This is like sugar, but it has like a zipper. And these are really popular types of packaging right
now.
They are. It's kind of a growing trend towards this type of packaging because it's very appealing on the shelf and good storage, lasts longer on the shelf, that kind of thing. So we're seeing
We've gone into some slides. So basically this is what we're looking at. So do you want to speak to these?
Yeah, so crinkly, doesn't stretch, foil lining, sealed for freshness. So we just showed some examples of those materials.
Yeah.
And if you're not sure, you can check our WasteWise app.
The WasteWise app.
We put in all the different materials that we could think of. So things like net bags, like from avocados and oranges and onions, that kind of thing. What else? There's bubble wrap. Cheese packaging, the cling wrap that goes over meat trays and things like that. So it's a very big, broad category. And I started recycling it at home. And I had a little bag that I would clip onto the outside of my recycling bin. And I started filling the bag. I'm like, hold on, like, I need a bigger bin for this waste stream. So it's a pretty significant
part of it.
Waste stream now. So I've actually traded one of my recycle bins for my garbage can, and now I just have a little tiny garbage can and then a big recycle bin for this one.
That's the truth. I find that I could use a bigger recycle now. Mine's just always full on garbage day, and my garbage is like half, which feels good, right? Hopefully everybody's sort of starting to see that a little bit.
So this has to go to a depot. So that bin that has for depot is probably getting bigger and bigger for people.
Oh, absolutely. Yes.
Yeah.
Did we get through all the slides? I don't know. I think we did. No. We didn't. Here
so
we
these
go.
Are the it's just the two general grants that are participating in this pilot project, and then perhaps January 1st we'll see Lawrence Street also start collecting it.
Tell me this, Marcia, will they keep going with this project if it is well used? Is that the idea? The more people use it, they have to figure out the technology to recycle the stuff still as well, though.
Yeah, so they're going to develop the technology. The plan that I've heard from Recycle BC is that come January 1st, 2019, it will be mandatory. So this is a direction that they're committed to this technology, and what they're actually happening with the material is that it will be used, because it can't be recycled into new plastics, it will be used as a fuel source for coal-powered plants. Yeah,
awesome. Okay, so. We're out of time, but again, let's remind people that they can use the WasteWise app, and that specifically is called...
WasteWise Kamloops.
Yeah. And you can look that up on your app page and get it, and then you know exactly what you can put at the curb, what you can take to general grants, and make this program a success. Thank you for being here.
Thank you, Susan.
All right.